Welcome to today's video. I'm going to show you how to create an interior page of a coloring book like this using free online software. My name is Anna and I do videos on how to create, maintain and grow your KDP business. If you like videos like that, then make sure you hit the subscribe button and also smash that notification bell to receive notifications when I produce videos like this. And if you do like it, please give it a thumbs up. It's really appreciated. Thank you. So today we're going to be looking at how to create an interior page of a coloring book. Now, coloring books are very popular on Amazon. They sell extremely well, which demonstrated by the low bestsellers ranks and therefore have the potential to make a lot of money. Today, as I promised, I'm going to show you how to do this with a free software. But keep in mind, if you're using softwares like Illustrator or Affinity Designer, the same principles will apply. First, I'm going to show you how to do the background of the page, and then we are going to overlay an image on that to create our coloring book page. The software I'm going to be using today is called Gravit Designer. This is online software and it's free to use. When you sign up, you get 15 days of the pro version, which turns into the free version. Now, if you want to continue with the pro version, it costs $49 at the moment, and this is for a year. Now, the main differences between the free and the pro version are you get unlimited storage, you're able to download images up to 300 dpi, and you're also able to download the software to use offline. But of course, the free version will be good enough to do most projects. If you're going to be creating covers, I would suggest you to get the pro version, because you will need to download the cover as a 300 dpi image. So when we go to Gravit Designer, you're presented with a page like this. We need to create our page, so we need to enter the width and height. Now, this is very important because if you look at the page we're going to create here, we'll notice that the image goes from one edge of the page to the other. So we need to add on something called bleed. Now, we're going to be creating an 8.5 by 11 inch book. Now, we need to add on bleed because this image will be trimmed by Amazon when the book is printed. So we need to add 0.125 inches to the top and bottom of the page and 0.125 inches to the one of the vertical edges. So this means our book will be 8.625 by 11.250 inches. So we'll go and add that into Gravit Designer. So now we've got our page, and the first thing we need to do is to create the background. For the page background, we are going to go and search for an image. Now I use Vectezi here, but if you go to Google and put in free vector images, you will find plenty of sites. I really like Vectezi website because they have a great range of free and pro vector images. There are many images that you can download for free, but there is a limit to how many of these you can sell as a commercial project. And you do have to put in attribution to Vectezi in your book. So if you're planning to use their images for your KDP book, I suggest to go with pro version, which I think is currently around $108 for the year. And that allows you to use them in commercial projects, and there is no limit to the number of sales of those projects you can make. There are many here that would be appropriate to be used in coloring books. And remember, they can all be converted into black and white images in your vector software. But I'm going to create a Santa Claus on a Christmas background. So I'm going to put in Christmas background and then look through these images. And this was one I liked. So I click on download and then we'll go back to Gravit Designer and I'm just going to drag the SVG file which is vector, over onto our page. And so I'm just going to position this top corner and then press shift and just drag that down to fill the page. There we have our background. Now I'm going to make this invisible for the moment. Okay, so the next thing is we are going to need our image of Santa. So I'm going to go back to Victeezy and put in Santa Claus. Scroll down and find our image of the Santa, which is this one, and again click on download now. When we download this, you will see here that it downloads an EPS and a JPG file. So we need to convert the EPS file into SVG. Now, this is very easily done. So just go to Google and search EPS to SVG, and you will get tons of websites. I usually use this one, convertio.co. It's quick and really easy to use. We've chosen to convert an EPS file into an SVG file. So click on here to locate our file and just click on convert, which will take a couple of seconds, pretty quick. And then we download that. So we go back to Gravit Designer, and then we are going to drag this across to our page like so. So I've got our Santa here, and we are going to position this on the page. Click on the corner, hold down the left mouse button, press shift and just expand. And then we're going to position this on our page like so. Now we have our Santa here, which is a color image, and we don't want that. So we put a bounding box around our Santa, and first of all, we're going to change the borders to a thick black line. So over here on the right hand side, click on color fill and choose black, and then where it says points, we're going to change that to 2 or 3. I think 2 is better. So now our image has thick black lines around all the components. So now we need to get rid of the colors. So we go over to fill, click on that, and just click on white. There it is. I'm just going to enlarge this slightly, and I'll show you a couple of problems here with the image. So as you can see here, there are several layers that should be removed to make the final image more clear and easy to color. So I'm going to remove all unnecessary layers. Depending on the image, you probably won't need to do this, but I just wanted to make it look a bit nicer. Okay, so we'll reduce the size so we can see the overall image. I think that looks pretty good. And then all we need to do is go down to the layers panel on the left hand side, click on the eye icon to make our background visible again, and there we have our Santa on the background. Now we need to go and put this into PowerPoint to create our book. So what we need is save this as a PNG file. So click on File, click on Export, click on PNG Image, and that will have downloaded it to your computer. So now we need to go to PowerPoint, click on New, delete all that. Now we need to change the size of this to our page size. And to do so, just click on Design and Page Setup, and I will put 8.625 by 1125. Now, obviously, we are going to create more than one page. So all we need to do is just click on the page on the left hand, copy and paste. Okay, so now all we need to do is drag our image onto our PowerPoint page. And you will see here, we've got our first page of the coloring book, which I think you'll agree looks pretty good. So you can do the same now, and you can build up all these pages up to how many pages you want, and you will then save or export to PDF, and you'll save that and create your book. So when it comes to uploading the interior to KDP, because there is a bleed, you'll need to click on this option in the bleed settings. So now you're gonna want to create numerous pages, and a little trick you might want to consider doing is when you go to Victeezy, if you go to the right hand side and click on designer's name, you will see other artworks that this artist has produced. And you can go and get the images that are very similar in a style to the ones you've already created for your coloring book page, so that then you can create this whole coloring book that has a similar style and feel, and therefore you're producing something a bit more cohesive. So that's it for now. That's a relatively simple way of creating a coloring book interior page. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments below and I do my best to answer them all. Well, that's it for now. Thank you very much for watching, and don't forget to hit that subscribe button, smash the notification bell, and give it a thumbs up if you liked the video. And you have a great day. See you soon. Bye-bye.